something that you probably should know. It's that Slumdog Millionaire Bollywood flow. And real friends never hearing from me. Big fans like the Bollywood.
Thank you. can rise while you're on the stage. Remove your caps as we honor tonight's national anthem with help from our own David Hani. He's also a senior. Take it away, David.
MUTV's live stream of club hockey. We're here at the Ponds of Brookfield on a crisp Friday night. It's senior night. The crowd is packing. I'm Ed Unger. I'm your play-by-play guy here with my partner, Grant Becker. Say hello, Grant.
How you doing, guys? Thanks for joining us on this Friday night. It's good to be here with you, Matt.
So, Grant, we got a Butler team that hasn't been so great this year. It's 3-4. A little bit rough. They're giving up more goal, or they're giving up double the amount of goals they have against them. What are the keys to the game for Marquette to take advantage?
Yeah, Marquette looking like coming in on paper, they're the better team. What they need to do is impose themselves in this game early. They've got a huge crowd here tonight. If they can get up early, they can put Butler out of this game immediately in the first period. They can keep this crowd involved all night. Marquette's a high octane offense. That first line, we'll talk about them all night long because they will be scoring goals. If they can get things going right away, that'll be good for this team. Keep the crowd involved and get themselves on top early.
And that has been a point of contention all season long. They have came out of the gates quite slowly. So let's see if they change that tonight. We got the drop. Mitchell Lena is going to take the faceoff for Marquette, and we're about to get rolling here at the Ponds of Brookfield. Elena, he loses the draw. 23, Connor McMahon dumps it in deep for the Butler Bulldogs. Retain up the boards, up to Chip Natwara. Clears the center ice. It's swung across in the neutral zone. Dumped back in by Butler. It looks to me there's no icing on that. Natwara up the boards. Butler keeping it in. It's swatted down. Bankovic ditches it up. Marquette having trouble getting in, and they do get it in the zone, but Butler will regain possession, and then Marquette is going to look for a line change.
Yeah, both teams struggling here to get possession in their offensive zones early. Turnover here by Butler gives Marquette a chance.
It's Kennedy with the shot there wide. Kennedy looks out front, nothing doing on that. He clears it around behind. That's Stillman looking for the jamming in front of the net.
Nice job there by the Butler goalie, O'Reilly, to get involved in that play. Break up the pass, would have been an easy goal for Marquette there. Keeping this a scoreless game.
Stillman skating around. He dishes it back to the point. That's Shipoff with a rocket off, but it is deflected wide. Marquette with a good job in the forecheck here. They're keeping it in the zone. Back out to the point. Bankovic keeps it in. Stillman clears it out front. Nothing happening there for Marquette. Still continuing the good forecheck. Kennedy gets it back to the point. And another shot is wide from Shipa, and I've heard he has the hardest slap shot on the team.
Yeah, he launched a big one, and Stillman came in there, collapsed on the goalie, and ref gave it a look, said there's nothing there. They'll keep playing. Marquette regains possession in their defensive zone, bringing it up. The Shippa.
That Shippa taking it up. He's looking in deep. He looks for, oh, he scores! He absolutely roofed it right there. And Marquette will jump out with an early lead as they score just a minute 45 into the game.
Big, awesome individual effort there from Shippa. He picked the puck up near his own blue line, or behind his own net. Got around a few guys in his defensive zone. Takes it all the way up the ice. Gets around the last defender. Cuts inside. Near post, top shelf. Beautiful goal, man.
Beautiful goal. Goalie had no chance. He was sprawled down in the butterfly position. He was not recovering. That's Pavlos. He wins the faceoff for Marquette. It's cycled over to Kellen Buddy. Buddy tries to chip at the boards, but it is kept in by the Butler Bulldogs, and that goes out of play.
First faceoff here in the Marquette defensive zone.
Let's see if they can win the draw. Pavlos on the draw. He loses it. But that's Lately. He's able to take it out. That's a Gradstone. He's going with the wheels right now. He shoots and it goes high and wide. Marquette keeping it in with Pavlos. He keeps it in deep. Corey Quinn battling around the boards out here.
Lately tried to go at the early shot there off the backhand. Catch the goalie off guard. Just a little high.
Like the idea though there. Marquette trying to regain their own possession back in the zone. It's sent up out to Pavlos. He's looking in deep. He drops it off to Lately, and that is a shot right on goal. But Butler's goalie will save it and hang on to it. That's Matt Thornley.
Yeah, right to the pads. Easy save there. Love it. Marquette's first faceoff in their offensive zone. Crowd's getting into this one here. An early goal for Marquette, like we talked about. One of the keys to the game. Getting ahead early. They did a nice job there. A sweet individual effort from Mark Shippa.
Tamanaki wins the draw. It is still in the Marquette zone. Goes down deep. No icing again for Butler. This is Matthew Pulley. He clears it out to center ice. And Butler dumps it back in the zone, and they're going to go for a change.
And Butler a bit overwhelmed right now by Marquette's size, speed, and possession of the puck. Nice hit there, right at the blue line.
Butler's taking it in, and it's back out to center ice. And they call him on change. It's going to be a 2-on-2 as he brings it in the zone here. With the shot, it's deflected wide. Bankovic looking to squeeze one in. The Butler going will hang on, finally freezes it.
Looks like we got a delayed penalty here, Matt. Ref's gonna bring somebody into the box for a cross check. Marquette looks like they're gonna go up on the power play early. 2 minutes cross checking to Butler's number two.
Noah Brayton.
First penalty kill of the game here. Marquette's gonna go on the advantage with the one goal lead. Just a minute or 3 minutes and 12 seconds into this contest. Marquette gonna look to double their lead.
Yeah, keep an eye on Brian Kennedy. He has 4 power play goals this year, so keep an eye out for him.
Kennedy
taking the draw.
Marquette's leading scorer with 33 points this season.
Back to the point, Corey Quinn skating around with it. He looks for it in the slot. Ooh, and just missed the backdoor pass. Tomonic back to the point. It's cycled across to Shippa. Shippa looking, he's holding. He passes it back across to Corey Quinn. Quinn down deep, back up to Quinn at the point. Marquette's looking for that open opportunity right here to put one in. Shippa hanging, he's looking. He gets the pass back door.
Great patience here by Marquette on the power play, waiting for the right opportunity to take the shot. Not gonna give up possession easy.
Stillman still skating around with it. He's flowing around. He gets it back to the point. That's Shippa, he gives it over to Quinn. Quinn back over to Stillman, and he shoots it right into the gut. And that's a 4th save tonight from Thornley already from Butler. Marquette is dominating the offensive zone right now.
Early there on that power play, there's an opportunity for DeSalvo to take a shot. He was in kind of in a 2-on-0 situation. He looked up, tried to give the pass to his teammate. His teammate wanted him to take a shot so he could crash in for the rebound. Just a little miscommunication on a good opportunity for Marquette.
Number 15, Brian Kennedy is out on the ice, so look out for him. Like I mentioned, 4 power play goals this season already.
Yeah, Kennedy and Stillman leading the team with 15 goals apiece. Those two are part of that top unit that we talked about before the game.
Back up to Natwara. He's holding it. He cycles it down the boards to Kennedy. Kennedy looking across. He's got open man. Ooh, just a little bit wide there for grad student Christian Lately. It's back to the point. Brandon Natwara. He strips it back off to Plotz. Plots over to Kennedy. Oh, and it goes wide again.
Not sure how that one didn't find the back of the net, Matt. I thought it was going all the way.
Kennedy, he's skating. He's looking. He's holding. He cycles it back. Corey Quinn with the shot. and it'll be frozen once again. It'll be another face-off in the Butler zone.
I think Plotz is looking for a little more traffic out in front of the net. C's kind of parted before he took that shot. It's an easy save for the Butler goalie, Sean O'Reilly, who's had to make quite a few saves here early on in this contest.
Kennedy, he loses the draw. Butler will clear. 26 seconds left in the penalty. 15-11 here remaining at the Ponza Brookfield. Marquette is up 1-0, courtesy of Mark Shipbaugh goal. Marquette, they send it in deep. Is it Podolis looking around? He's skating, he sends it back to the point to Natwara. Natwara, he's looking, he passes it back to Podolis. And Butler will get it, but they can't clear just yet. Kennedy pinches in and he keeps that in. Plotz with the shot a little bit wide there. Puck still in the zone by Marquette, and a nice little pass down to Podolis. He's down the zone. The penalty is over for Butler, so it is even strength again. Natwara with it.
Golden opportunity at the back door there for Brian Kennedy. Couldn't get a stick on it.
This is Brayton right out of the box for Butler. He's offside, so he can't touch that puck. Nawara scoops it up to center ice. Butler regains possession. They look to send it in, and they send it right back to Marquette. Man, Butler has not had a lot of possession tonight of the puck.
No, Marquette doing a nice job. As soon as they lose it, collapsing on this Butler team to get it back nice and quick.
Elena, he's skating around the boards. He sends it back up to the point. It skips out, and Butler will get it out of the zone. This is Connolly. He sends it in deep. Buddy, he's holding on to the puck. He's trying to get rid of it. He gets it up along the boards. Marquette will break out once again. Barnes, he's holding on to the puck, and he gets hit. Oh, it's a three in front of the net, but Marquette cannot take advantage as Butler just scoops out, bracing for life.
Patrick Connolly with a huge hit on the boards there for Butler, trying to get something going for this Bulldogs team that has had zero possession of the puck in their offensive zone. First shot on goal there for Butler. It wasn't much of a shot.
First shot on goal comes 13:26 into the period. You don't like it like that. This is Christopher Dolan. He's skating around behind the boards. He's looking for a man. Marquette was on the change there. He ships a great pass across to Morrow, and he cannot find the back of the net. This is Telmanic. He sends it back down to Morrow. Morrow tries to play it off the boards, but a little too hard, and it comes back down into the Marquette zone, and Butler will change once again.
Butler doing everything they can to keep these legs fresh as they've been outskated so far by this deep Marquette team.
This is Morrow. He's at center ice. He loses and has it turned over there. And Butler just kind of scraping it in there. Gives it right back over to Joey Bertain.
Yeah, Butler looking for these dump and chase opportunities, trying to develop some possession in the zone. But they can't beat Marquette to the puck, which is probably the main principle of dump and chase, is chasing the puck. All they've got right now is the dump part. They need to win the chase.
Indeed, it's been a lot of dump and not chase, but change. They're just changing because they're getting outskated out here.
Yeah, Marquette coming out early, making a big impact in this game. Only one goal to show for a lot of possession and quite a few shots. They'll need to get a little bit more clinical as we go on here.
Kennedy, he loses the draw to Connor Mann. It's set up along the boards. It's kept there.
Stillman
it.
Left it back there. Bad turnover.
And this is Gregone on the break. He shoots it, and Robbie Arner will eat it up. That is Marquette's goalie number one. He has been the rock all season long.
Yeah, Stillman was looking to get a little fancy there at the point. It's not the place where you want to make a silly turnover like that. Butler had an opportunity, best opportunity in the game for them, and Arner there makes an easy save.
Arner this season, he's got 721 save percentage with a 2.88 goals against average. He has been stellar to say the least.
Yeah, 2.88 goals per game average is pretty good in the league where there's a lot of scoring, Matt.
Indeed. This is Marquette's top line here. Kennedy holding up against the boards. He's looking around for someone. He holds still. That's intercepted by Butler, but Stillman puts one and misses it just wide. This is Del Savo looking for the backdoor pass. He cannot get that. Butler looks like they will be able to break out here. Oh, and there's a terrible pass there, and Marquette will regain possession once again.
Marquette all over this Butler team, and they can feel the pressure early on here on the road. It's a long trip for this team. Marquette just 15 minutes away.
Stillman, he takes it in the zone. He's going around. He sweeps out in front. It's a loose puck. Butler's able to clear it, but it gets right back out to the point. And Stillman keeps it in and sends it back down to Del Savo. Del Savo with a good poke check there. Butler will regain. And there's a dump and, like I said, a change as Butler will change lines once again.
Yeah, right now the dumping is not so much an offensive strategy as a defensive strategy. Just get this down in their zone so we can get it changing quick. Could be tough for Butler come the second period when they're switching from the other end. Their bench isn't close by, and they're going to be stuck out on the ice for a while, and that's when Marquette should really capitalize on the depth that they've got.
Marquette just offside, sir, so that faceoff will be in between the blue line and the red line at the circle.
Man, I like the way that all of the Marquette lines have touched the ice. It doesn't have to be the top line or anything in between that. Everybody's coming out on the ice for Marquette is doing such a nice job keeping the pressure high, playing hard, playing physical hockey. They're just generally quicker than this Butler team, and they've imposed their will on this game right away.
Absolutely. Butler wins the faceoff. He still loses possession of the puck there. It's stuck in the neutral zone. Marquette, and they're stuck in their own zone right now, trying to break out. This is 23, Connor Mahan. Oh, he shoots, and that's a good chance for Butler right there, but they're not able to capitalize it, and Marquette will break out. This is number 11, Lee Barnes, looking in. He passes it off, and the shot is just blocked.
Marquette making a move at the blue line there. Christopher Dolan doing a nice job to realize at that moment that his teammate was making a cut back. He was going to go in offsides. Pays attention, glides down the blue line until he's safe to go in. Heads up play by Dolan.
Butler just chips that back out and gives it right back to Marquette. And that's a shot on goal by Barnes. Oh, and he roofs it once again. And that is number 17, Christopher Dolan.
Lee Barnes came in with the puck there for Marquette. Got the initial shot. Dolan comes down, gets the rebound, and then gets his own rebound. Not a lot of rim there, just throws it at the top of the net. Would have knocked the water bottle off, but this poor Butler goalie's got no water.
Yeah, another great finish there from Marquette. The goalie was down, they lifted that top Cheddar, and Marquette will go up 2-0 with 10-10 left here at the Ponce Brook Field.
Top shelf goals only for the Marquette Golden Eagles tonight, taking on the Butler Bulldogs. Grant Becker here with Matt Unger, back in action.
Marquette wins the draw. That's Bertain, who tries to chip it up along the boards, but Butler will keep it in. That's a rare sight to see tonight. Marquette with a great two-line pass up to Moreau. Moreau holding it in the zone. He lost his footing there, but it's still Marquette puck as Telemann puts it in front. Ooh, and that is a great save right there from Thorne with the glove.
Mental mistake there from Butler to drive in front of their own net with the puck. Easy takeaway. Marquette gets a shot out of the deal, but no goal.
That's when they tell Monty taking the draw, and he loses it. Butler tries to clear it up around the board, but Marquette does a good job of pinching. But Butler will break out here. This is Keenan Casey along the boards. He gets hit, and Marquette just regains possession once again. Man, Butler cannot get any offense going here tonight. Tomanik, he's holding in the zone. He looks across. Nothing doing for Bankovic there. Bertain, he's pitching up along the boards. But Butler will be able to squeeze it out. And this is Chris Smith for Butler holding it in. He's looking for someone. He takes a shot right in the chest, and Arner eats it up and lets it go. He's letting the play on. There's
he's
no forecheck.
Playing NHL. He says, you know what? Let's just keep the play. I don't want to hear any whistles. We don't need to stop this. Let's keep the fans in it. Toss it out. Arner confident in net.
Butler taking it. That's a good pass right there and a good save from Arner on Joey Cargone.
Arner got down nice and quick there to deny Butler an opportunity.
And the fans here are singing Stacy's mom quite loudly. They are into the game. They're loving it out here at Ponce Brook Field.
Fans having fun. The team's having fun. Trying to turn all the possession they've had into goals. Opportunity here. Bounces off the boards the wrong way for Marquette.
Butler clears up on the boards. He gives it right back to Marquette. And that is your top guy, Brian Kennedy, coming in the zone. It's an offside.
Couldn't quite get out of the zone in time. That was Johnny Stillman, who was still trapped down there. He was the one looking for the break earlier. Would have been a two-on-one opportunity there for Marquette. Not a good look for Butler, but they were saved by the boards. Funny little bounce off the break in the glass.
Got 8:33 left here at the Ponce Brook Field. Matt Unger here on the play-by-play with my brother, Grant Becker, on color. That shot's blocked. Shippa at the point here, and he has one tonight. It's passed in to Podolis. And this is Corey Quinn. Oh!
What a goal for Marquette. Matt Mogensen, or Matthew Foley. Nice pass on the back end. Sends it out in front of the net. One-time finish there. William Podolis.
Yeah, and Marquette, the forecheck is really paying off here. They got three goals in just 12 minutes. It looks like the wheels are going off the tracks right now for Butler. They can't do anything on offense.
Yeah, we said Marquette needs to come out and play well early because we know they play well late in games. We know they can wear down on teams as it goes on, but they put it in early, and this one could get ugly really quick if it keeps going this way for Marquette, and Butler continues to give up possession of the puck.
Indeed it could. Matthew Pulley fresh off a goal. He takes it into the zone. It's deflected right out in front. Another great chance from Marquette in the offensive zone.
Nearly an own goal there for Butler.
Dolan passes it back off to Shippa. Great backdoor pass. Oh, he hits him out front, but Butler's goalie Matt Thornley will eat it up and keep him in the game a little bit longer.
Yeah, good opportunity there for Marquette. They did a nice job setting up in that corner. That's where that last goal came from. Like to develop in that little Gretzky area, you know, and created one opportunity that turned into a goal and then another nice opportunity there. Good save for Butler.
Colin Tomanek on the draw. He wins it. He sends it back over, but the Marquette can't keep it in. It's a bouncing puck. They regain possession. Tomanek takes it back into the zone. He takes a clap bomb and a great blocker save right there from Thornley. Another great pad save from Thornley, but Marquette is just applying the pressure right now. Tomanek down low. He skips it right off there to Christopher Moreau. Moreau looking back to the boards. He sends it out to Pohl. Tomanek keeping it in. Bankovic sends it back out to Natwara. Natwara will keep it in as well. And they're playing, they're forechecking very hard right now. Looks out front, and Thornley will hold that. Marquette will have another offensive zone faceoff.
Marquette playing with two players there below the line. And Tomanek doing a nice job to set things up. But when you talk about him, you got to talk about the hair. Best lettuce on the team. Flowing out of the helmet. Looking great coming down the ice on that fast break there.
You like to see the lettuce out of the bucket. It just makes your game that much better.
Absolutely. It's really a major key to success, Matt.
Butler trying to get some offense going. They dump and chase. They actually have a little bit of chase here. Two boards pinching, but they're still hanging back quite high. They're not going to get any offensive going with that. And I actually do have to give props while we're talking lettuce. Number 16, Josh Braun for Butler, has some fantastic flow as well.
He really does. He's got all kinds of locks coming out of that hood.
Butler, a little bit of forecheck of their own right now.
Game picking up a little bit of pace here late on in the first period. 6.5 minutes to go in this contest. Marquette leading 3-0.
Blatt scoops out the center ice and almost a 3-1 for Marquette. But a great play from Patrick Connolly of Butler to chest that down and save the scoring opportunity.
Yeah, Marquette looking for some of these longer opportunities, some of those full-length passes here. Like you said, two-line pass.
Stillman picks it up along the boards. Marquette looking to break out. An ill-advised pass, and that looks like it's going to be icing, and it will be.
A couple of miscommunications there from Marquette. The center was looking for the headman pass coming out of the zone. He had an opportunity there, and he's turned around to his teammates. Guys, I'm here. They just dropped it back to the defender and let him bring it out. Ordinarily, that wouldn't work, though, because you'd have Butler offensive players staying in the zone attacking that defender, but they really, really aren't putting a whole lot of guys in this forecheck. It's really been a one-man forecheck, leaving two guys back behind him to try and maybe create a little bit of a zone pressure, but it's not working for Butler right now. They're going to have to change something.
And this looks like more like a survival for Butler right now as opposed to an attack. Marquette ships it up, and that looks like it's going to be another icing against Marquette. Butler getting a little forecheck going here, trying to get some momentum.
This is about as much as we've seen Butler play in their offensive zone so far in this game. I guess we haven't talked at all about the Marquette defense, but a testament to them. They've done a nice job. They go fetch the puck from behind their own net. They get it out of the zone. They don't worry about anything, all right?
Yeah, you got to look at the big bodies. You got Colin Redmond at 6'4". You got Brandon at war. Mark Shippa, another big body in there. They lay the body, and they're also very good. They're good with the finesse of their stick as well to poke check it away. Now being offside on Marquette, so we'll have the faceoff right outside the zone.
3-0 Marquette leads, 5:45 remaining in the first period here from the ponds of Brookfield. Grant Becker and Matt Unger on the call for MUTV Sports. We're here with Marquette Wire's Jamie Schilling. Follow him on Twitter at Captain G America. Got Brian Georgeson running the camera. We're having fun out here in Brookfield.
Butler tries to get into the zone. That's Buddy right there. He sends it across to a fellow defender. Marquette looking for another long pass, and it will work. And this is Hollis coming into the zone. He gets chucked off the puck. Great hit right there from Butler. Marquette clears in. That was outside the red line, but Butler did touch it, so no icing here. This is Eric Gentry taking it out of his own zone. He's skating the whole length of the ice right now. He dishes it off. He looks back for a shot. There's number 16 with a great shot on that, but Robbie Arner with a good save right there with his pads and minimizing the rebounds.
All three of Butler's best breakouts so far have been one-man efforts. We saw Conley do it earlier. We just saw Gentry do it now. We saw Keenan Casey do it. That's really the three best breakouts Butler's had so far. You can't rely on that all night because those guys are going to be exhausted come halfway through the second period.
Marquette trying to apply the pressure here. Farr's got a little bit of space. His number 17, Joey Gargone. He clears it up to Connolly, who just sends it into Arner, and he lets it go again. We're playing NHL 16 out here, I guess, for Arner tonight.
I tell you what, if Butler gets the opportunity, Arner's going to get some snow in his face.
Big battle here in the neutral zone as Butler tries to chip it in. They will. They got an opportunity here. Oh, great play by Redmond there to just place the ball, play off the puck. Oh, right in front of the net. And another shot just wide. Butler getting some opportunities here, but really not taking advantage of them. And they're not even really testing Arner.
Yeah, sent that one wide from the point. Great opportunity. They had a screener in front of the net, and they couldn't use him.
This is Dolan. Marquette's on a 3-on-2. He passes it back. Oh, and a great save once again from Thornley to keep the score 3-zip.
Barnes isn't going to have many opportunities better than that one right there, in alone in front of the net. All kinds of space to work with. He had a teammate with him.
Battle on the boards here as Marquette tries to keep it in, but Butler will be able to get it out of their zone. Oh, maybe not.
A moment of relief there for Butler, but it doesn't last long. Nice hit in the corner by the Butler defender. That was 21, Kyle Kortbein.
Butler clears it down, no icing. Looks like both teams will change here. We got 4:03 left here at the Ponds at Brookfield. Marquette currently up 3-0 on the visiting Butler Bulldogs here on senior night. Oh, and Tomanek dresses it just high over the glove side.
He was looking for that top shelf near post, couldn't find it.
Marquette keeping in, Tomanek playing down to the boards. And that Chippa has got to hold up right there. He regains possession. He's looking all the way across to his boy Tomanek, and that will give the Marquette a chance in the zone. A takeaway there, and it looks still not frozen. It's still free, and now the refs will blow the whistle, and that was just all over. That was right in the crease.
Heads-up play there by Thornley to close those legs. The puck's here. I've got it. I'm going to take care of that. Marquette nearly kicked it in. Thornley almost saved him by popping it back out and giving Marquette another opportunity. You see a player kick it in, maybe just let it go if you know it's not going to be a goal. Could have been his best opportunity there to make a save, but he does a nice job recovering in a tough situation. And that was one that really, really should have been cleared by the Butler defense. Error in front, Marquette pressing hard, quick team. They're all over this Butler defense right now.
That's Kennedy laying the hit on the Butler player there. Nat Warren tries to keep it in, but he is beat. And we might have a 2-on-1 here for Butler. This is Connolly. Oh, great defensive play right there. And Nat Warren will regain possession for Marquette. He plays it around behind the net to Poley, who plays it back to Nat Warren. Now we're looking for an entry pass into the zone. Butler's got a one-man forecheck going on once again here.
Yeah, playing the pretty unconventional 1-2 forecheck. Not that you see that too often. That's the forecheck of a team that's trying to conserve its energy.
Matt Warren regains possession for the Golden Eagles here. He sends it up along the boards, but Kennedy is not able to corral that, and they get right back to Butler. DeSalvo, he takes it along the backside of the boards. He's looking for his attackers to come up. Plays it back to the point. Nat Wara plays it back down low underneath to Stillman. He holds it. He's getting checked real hard. Kennedy, oh, great poke check right there by Butler goalie Thornley. Now the puck will get out, and Butler's going to try to go on a little break here. Oh, never mind. They're going to dump and change, and Arner will release the puck once again.
3-on-2 opportunity for Butler, and they go for the dump before they even get into the zone. Not an aggressive play, not a confident play from Butler. They're just looking to get out of this period with the score the same as it is right now. Maybe hope for a break. A lucky one going
Kyle Corpy takes the shot. That is blocked by Nat Wara. It's, oh, and a beefy rebound right there, but no Butler players there to take advantage. That's a testament of a lacking forecheck.
Butler's starting to look tired here. We're just in the first period.
Kristen Lately plays it out in front, and that gets blocked by about three Butler bodies. This is number 17, Eric Gentry. He dumps it in. They're changing once again. These are some really short shifts here from Butler, 20, 25, 30 seconds.
Like I said, Matt, their team is trying to get out of the first period, keep things the way they are right now. Maybe they'll try to regroup after this period during the intermission. But they're playing a little bit scared right now, to be honest.
That's Bertain. He keeps it in with a great play with the glove. We got there to set it out in front. Nothing happening there. Butler's really flooding 3-4 bodies right in front of the net right now to block some shots. A little battle in neutral zone. We got a minute left here to go at the Ponza Brookfield. MUTV's live broadcast. I'm Matt Unger here with my friend Grant Becker. We got Marquette 3-0 lead already here on senior night.
1-on-3 opportunity here for Butler.
Yeah, Connolly just, I mean, there's nothing much you can do there if you're a Connolly as a player. You just have to give it in and hope for the best, but nothing doing there again for Butler.
Yeah, Connolly has been one of the aggressors for Butler tonight. A lot of times when we talk about offensive possession, it's been him with the puck for Butler. They have some talented players. They've had a couple opportunities to get into this game, but they really haven't taken those chances. They're going to have to get a little bit more aggressive if they want to make their mark against Marquette here in Brookfield. Broken wood there.
There's a broken twig. He'll need to get a new piece of lumber right there. We got about 12 seconds left here. No icing there, and this should be just about it for the period as Marquette looks like we're going to ice it out.
Great first period here for Marquette. We talked about them coming out playing well early. They did exactly that. They get the 3-0 lead in the first period, capitalize on a couple of nice chances, a couple team goals, an individual effort, and I would say all around a comprehensive good period from Marquette.
Yeah, I would have to say Coach Will Jurgensen would have to be very pleased with this first half effort here.
Yeah, the seniors have to be proud of the way they've come out so far and played on senior night. Like we said, this can get progressive, this can get better for Marquette. They're a fast team, they put the pressure on. If this thing gets physical, they have some big guys. All right, Johnny Stillman, he stands at 6'5". He's got to be the tallest guy on the ice tonight. And I don't think Butler wants to get into a physical battle with this Marquette team, not with speed, not in terms of hitting, nothing like that. If Butler wins, they're going to have to win with speed. They're going to step up their game. They're going to get a little bit more aggressive, maybe start pinching when they're in the offensive zone. They're going to set two guys down low on that forecheck. That's really the key for me if I'm the Butler team right now.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know why they're playing so late back right now. I mean, I know the period didn't go the way they wanted it to, obviously, but if you're down 3 goals, the game is still within reach at this point. You've got 2 more periods left. You really have to start sending some more guys along the board to pinch.
Yeah, Butler has an opportunity to get themselves back into this one. Marquette hasn't put them away. They can't get complacent. They can't come back out in the second period and be happy with a 3-0 lead. Hockey's a quick game. Goals come quick, and they come in bunches.
Especially in club hockey.
You got a wild crowd here tonight. If they suddenly go quiet, who knows what could happen to Marquette. Butler could jump into this game. They'll react to the silence in this building if they can create it. But like I said, they need to be aggressive in order to make that situation a possibility.
Yeah, indeed, indeed, indeed. So we're going to take a break here at the Ponza Brookfield MUTV live stream. I'm Matt Unger here with my friend Grant Becker on color, and we'll be back at the start of the second period. My mama don't like you, but she likes everyone. And I never liked to admit that I was wrong. But I've been so caught up in my job. Did you see what's going on with my right now? My bed is sleeping on my own. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. If you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. That you made me feel strong. For the love, no life and nothing at all. Never felt so long in my world, don't know. Was I a fool to let you break down my walls? Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself.
Thank you.
and the boys have been brought out, and so are we. We're back on the air here. MUTV's live broadcast from the Ponds of Brookfield. In case you're just tuning in, I'm Ed Unger, your play-by-play man, here with my friend Grant Becker on color.
Yeah, man, we've got a good contest going here. Marquette jumping out to the early lead on senior night, 3-0, starting the second period here, and it's been all Marquette so far. Butler with a couple opportunities here and there on the break, but nothing's going in for them.
And the DJ here just played Come On Eileen, and the crowd was indeed ignited by that.
Kids, parents, college students, everybody was loving it. They were loving the hockey in the first period. They didn't even need music on. They were singing. They were having a great time. And the players are having a good time, too. Butler going to try and make an impact here in the second period. Marquette, they've got to know it's going to be a different period. Trouble for Butler here, though, is going to be making those substitutions. They were going with really short shifts like we talked about. They would dump and change as often as possible, but now their bench is going to be on the other side. It's going to be just that much more difficult to make those changes. And this is where Marquette can really, really impose their will. This is where they can show off all that speed, their physicality. They can really pin Butler in their own zone and really be possession maniacs.
And we're going to have the MU Wire beat reporter for club hockey, Jamie Schilling. He'll be joining us a few minutes into the period, so stay tuned for that. We're about to drop the puck here, the start of the second period. The refs are getting things on the road.
We got to make sure we thank our tech guy here, Brian Georgeson. He set everything up. He's running the camera. He's reminding me to change the graphics. He's doing everything right now, so we got to thank him for his efforts and knowledge, because we really wouldn't be able to do a darn thing out here if it wasn't for Brian.
We would not be able to do a darn thing without Brian, parentheses, GOAT Georgeson. We would not indeed.
Brian would be the greatest ever, the GOAT, if it wasn't for the fact that he's a Blackhawks fan.
That
unforgivable.
That is true. I agree with that.
Of course, we probably have plenty of Blackhawks fans listening to this broadcast. So, you know, nothing negative about the Blackhawks to say here.
Nothing at
nothing.
All.
No, only good things.
Only positive. I really love them and their fans.
I love Jonathan Toews.
And Patrick Kane. All right, we're about to drop the puck here. Mitchell Lane is going to take the draw from Marquette as we get going here at the second period. The Ponds of Brookfield, Marquette will win the draw. It's cleared up into the zone for Butler. They're looking to cycle it across and get breakout. And they're able to clear it in deep. And they got a little bit more of a forecheck going on so far. Patrick Conley pitching in for Butler, but the puck squirts around to the other side. Marquette with a good clearing pass to try to get out of the zone. And this is number 17, Christopher Dolan, who takes it in. He passes it off. It goes back to Dolan. He tries to put it in front, but Matt Thornley of Butler says no as he poke checks it away. Marquette keeping the great forecheck going on here. But Butler will be able to break out here just a little bit. And Eric Gentry, he takes a shot. That goes just wide. And Marquette gets it back out to center, and they're going to skate here. This is Lee Barnes taking it into the zone, and he gets dispossessed of the puck, and he will go for a change.
Butler coming out here a little bit stronger in the second period, doing a nice job to get the puck down to their end, and actually throwing a forecheck at Marquette.
Bertain scoops it in, and it gets deep in the zone for Marquette. Oh, and they're offside, so they're going to have to touch back up before they do anything, so Butler will have a little bit of breathing room here. They cycle it in, but Marquette is able to take it right away once again.
First period goals for Marquette from Christopher Dolan, Mark Shipbaugh, and William Powells. That has them up 3-0 here in the second period, where not much has happened so far in the first minute and a half of action. Cross ice pass there, can't connect.
And this is number 21, Christopher Moreau. He's on the pinch right now. The Butler is going to be able to it's not squeezed out just yet, as Talmadge is a little spin move. Oh, that's a very bad pass, and that's going to give Butler an opportunity here. 2-on-1. Oh, great back check from Marquette there to dispossess them, and that could have been ugly.
Yeah, Talmadge doing a nice job to make up for his mistake there as a lazy pass. Cared too much about the feathered hair. Just gave away the puck, but he did a nice job back checking, taking care of the mistake he made.
Redmond with a good poke there to knock it into the Butler zone. It comes back to Redmond, and he's looking for a guy. But Butler doing a good job of clamping down here, but he's able to find a man, and that's Christian Lely up the board. He passes it across. And just wide as Marquette was going for a little give-and-go action there. Butler taking it in deep into the zone. That's a great shot right there for number 2, Noah Brayton, but an even better save from Robbie Arnold with the blocker as he skips it aside.
good opportunity there for Butler, one of their better opportunities so far in the game. A nice shot from the top of the circle, and Arner saw it all the way, but again, a little bit more speed to that shot. Butler looking a little bit more confident here in the second period. Like we said, they're going to come out, they're going to play a little different game, and they have to be more aggressive here in the second period, and so far they've shown glimpses of that.
Josh Braun wins the draw for Butler, and they'll have a little bit of offensive zone possession time here. Josh Braun clears it down along the boards. Butler keeping in, but a good play right there from Brian Kennedy to dispossess Butler of the puck. And that's a terrible shot with no speed on it. And Buddy's going for the cross, for the breakaway, two ice pass. We will not do, but Marquette keeps in the zone as Kennedy gets a little trip there, but there's no call from the ref.
That was the MUTV zone. Kellen Buddy looking for the lengthy pass there, the hero pass. Couldn't connect on it, though.
Butler sends it deep in the zone. That's going to be icing. And with that, we are going to bring on the MU Wire beat reporter for club hockey. He's been following this team all year long. So, Jamie, what have you seen so far?
You know, a lot of the similars we've seen all season, Matt. You know, we usually Marquette comes out, they have a strong first period, and that's certainly been the case here, you know, in a 3-0 start. But keeping it up has usually been the difficulty for Marquette this season. Usually they let teams get back in the game, and usually that lead dwindles by about the 10-minute mark. We'll see if they can have a change here, hopefully.
And who's been the most impressive player thus far for you?
Thus far, I'd have to say Shipaw. I was talking to Robbie Arner earlier this season. He said, kid has a cannon. I'm certainly guessing this Butler goal he's feeling. O'Reilly might have a rough time waking up tomorrow.
Shipaw has had quite a few
looks like
bombs.
Marquette's going to go shorthanded here. Maybe a hooking.
Yeah, that's going to be
on number 15 for Marquette.
Brian Kennedy
going to the box. Marquette will go shorthanded for the first time in this game. Jamie, can you tell us what's coming up on Marquette's schedule? What does the season look like for them? What's next after this weekend of games?
After the season, after this weekend, the team advances to their regional game against Loyola, which they'll be in the silver division, which they actually won last year to advance to play Loyola. Robert Morris White, which they lost to, and that was the end of their season. So it's very similar to last season, but this year there's a lot more promise. And actually, on the topic of the current game right now, on the topic of penalties, this is something Coach Jurgensen's been working on all season with the guys. Penalties have been the killer, which has allowed teams to get right back in games. So
yeah, it's Colin Telmanac. It's 24 penalties a minute this season so far. It's 12 penalties he's picked up. And coaches always say it's tough to win games when you don't have the right amount of guys on the ice.
Certainly true. No, Colin's a tough kid.
And Jamie, so they were very close to getting an automatic bid into the tournament. What happened there? What's the difference in points?
I mean, it's all in rankings. In the standings, technically, I know Marquette would be second or first in the division, but
yes, it would be second.
It's based on the ACH rankings, and right now it's Colorado State and Colorado Mesa, if I'm not mistaken. They're both playing great hockey. Fun fact, Marquette actually beat Colorado State earlier in the Clash of the Corn tournament.
They did.
So it'll be interesting to see if their two roads pass.
Possibly a rematch, yes.
Absolutely. I think the more interesting one, though, would be a possible rematch with Nebraska. Marquette's one of their few losses of the season. That I know they're still very much alive, and they're keeping an eye on Marquette. I know that.
So, Jamie, is Marquette going to be hosting any of these games here at the Ponds at Brookfield in this regional tournament?
I know they'll be the home team as of right now. I'm not certain of the destination.
Thank you, Jamie Schillen. That's the Marquette
great to be here.
Wire beat reporter for club hockey. And we're going to get back to the action here. 14:53 left here at the Ponds at Brookfield. About Butler. 30 seconds left on the power play for the Butler Bulldogs.
Butler done a nice job so far in the power play to have possession of the zone. They've got a few shots off. They're doing a nice job. They've spread the ice here, making Marquette cover the entire zone. They're not just using half of it, trying to spread this Marquette defense out and look for an opportunity to slide into the slot and get a good shot off.
Marquette doing a good job of killing some time off here. There's a pinch at the board. This is going on for about 15 seconds now. And then they are able to clear, and that should about kill it off. 3-2-1 as Kennedy comes out of the box. 14:19 here left of the Ponds at Brookfield. Marquette up 3-0 or 3-0. They have not lost here in the Ponds at Brookfield since last November, so they are riding high off that home winning streak.
And this is what I was talking about with Butler near the end of that power play there. You saw Hunter Byram step up, make the pinch, and he was the last guy back. If he had been beat, he would have been in some serious trouble, but he went in, stepped up, got aggressive for this Butler team, and that's exactly what they needed. They want to get themselves back into this contest.
Eric Plotz with a good pass out to the point, but Thornley is able to hold on to that with the glove.
A good opportunity there for Marquette. They've done a nice job creating chances for their point men out here at the blue line.
That was actually some great skating. That was Eric Plotz, number 10, who brought it up all the way along the right side of the boards. Skating pretty fast there. Looks a little more like an offenseman to me.
Yeah, that's one of those things you see in club hockey. You see a lot more of these one-man breakouts than you do in the pros, or when you see teams like Boston College playing guys like Mr. Jack Eichel, you know.
Mr. Jack Eichel. Big fan of Mr. Jack Eichel myself.
Oh, are you, Matt?
Oh, indeed.
I'm not surprised to hear that.
Marquette loses the draw, and this is Noah Brady looking to break out for Butler. He puts on the brakes.
Breaking ankles.
He puts it back out to the point, gets blocked and deflected. And this is Talmadge, who makes a great pass out, and it's going to be a little breakout here for Marquette. Talmadge regains the puck. He's getting hampered down below on the boards, but he's able to keep possession there. This is Lee Barnes, who cycles it back up to the point. And that's Eric Plotz, the shot that goes just wide right. Marquette doing a good job of puck possession here as they've kept this forecheck going for about 30 seconds now. Talmadge, he picks it up along the boards again. He sends it back out to the point. And that was Plotz looking for a nice little backdoor pass, but not able to connect. Lee Barnes, he's getting hampered right there by the Butler defender. He's all over him. He's pushing him away. And then Butler is able to regain possession. Great defensive play right there for number four, Jordan Reisman, to dispossess Marquette the puck.
Great opportunity there for Butler. Best chance they've had all game. I would say Keenan Casey was there in the slot. Little pressure behind him, but he had an opportunity for the one-timer right there at the doorstep, and he couldn't connect with the puck.
And that's Connor Mahan with a nifty little move at center ice to get the puck in the zone for the Butler Blue Dogs. But Marquette will regain possession to the tune of Gianni Stillman. He skates around behind the boards. He's going all the way himself here. He's still going. He takes a shot, and that's a blocker save right there from Thornley. There's your little one-man breakout.
Yeah, big guy there, Stillman. He gets down the ice in just a few strides. He's like the Giannis Antetokounmpo of this Marquette men's club hockey team. Didn't take him long to get down the ice.
Kenny puts a pass a little bit behind Del Savo, and Marquette will lose possession of the puck, and it's back into the neutral zone. Kennedy, one move. He loses it there to Josh Braun with the great flow out the bucket. That might have been the reason he got that, I think.
Yeah, I would say so. Certainly the hair gives you a couple extra superpowers that maybe the rest of the guys on the ice don't have. We talk a lot about how possession is important in hockey, and now we have a better understanding of that with some of the new advanced numbers that we've got. We have a better idea of how important it is for teams to possess the puck. And Marquette, in the first period, did a great job of holding the zone, possessing
yes.
the puck. When they were in the neutral zone, the puck happened to be on Marquette players' sticks. And here Marquette breaks in. Good opportunity.
Losabe gets tripped up. Oh! And Kennedy sends it outside for Stillman, but he cannot connect. Shipoff sends it back down along the boards. This is Del Savo. Puck stick between his feet, and now it's like a cross check from behind, but no penalty called there.
DeSalvo got dumped to the ice there by Kyle Kortbeen, and we're going to keep playing on. What I was saying, though, about possession, Marquette hasn't had nearly as much of it in this second period, but they're trying to make that happen right now.
Buddy keeps it in, but loses it. We got 10:48 left here at the Ponds of Brookfield. Marquette up 3-0, and that'll be an icing on Butler, so we're going to get a faceoff back down in their zone.
Yeah, Buddy did a nice job there, realized he didn't have an opportunity to pinch. Starts skating backwards. Butler winger misses the puck, but he steps back in, makes the pinch, but he's not able to hold the zone. And we'll have a face-off in the Marquette offensive zone, looking to develop some more of that possession.
Yeah, the possession you're talking about, the Corsi and Femek numbers that have come out in the last 5 years, and they have been a bigger deal than people think. Like, you look at a team like the Calgary Flames, the Vancouver Canucks last year, who really were bottom third of the league, and it really showed in the playoffs. They weren't able to hold their own.
Right, yeah, and you talk about that, you can think season-to-season regression with that as well. You talk about a team like the Colorado Avalanche, who won their division after a huge boost in Patrick
yes.
Waugh's first year. But you looked at those numbers and you said, you know what, this team doesn't have what it takes to sustain this kind of success. High shooting percentage numbers, low possession numbers, those kinds of things are bound to slow down. You know, the shooting percentage is going to come down at some point. Those possession numbers have to come up if you want to keep winning games. It's tough to create shots when you don't have the puck. And the next year, Colorado misses the playoffs by a mile. They were out in the first round of the playoffs. And then again, Calgary, like you were talking about, Vancouver, like you were talking about, those two teams near the bottom of the stands again this year.
Yeah, indeed, indeed. And you should catch it up to you, because hockey, there's an element of luck to it. You know, the puck will take a funky bounce when it's on its when it's not flat in the ice. It'll take a funky bounce. You get a couple of rebound chances here and there. Get blasted with some power plays during a game, but usually it all ends up evening it out. Marquette's doing a good job of not even letting any luck be a part of this game.
Certainly, and goaltender skill is a part of that as well. There's a certain amount of luck to, you know, is the goalie on that night? Is the goalie better that night? Is he certainly better at saving the kinds of opportunities your team creates? And kind of weird matchups like that, you can't figure those kinds of things out on paper just from the numbers. And that's kind of where those numbers vary, and that's why you don't play the game on paper. You come out here and you actually play the game. But a lot of those times, those numbers just give you a better idea as to what we think should happen or kind of how the game works in general. And it's been a really great development for the game of hockey. Now, plenty of people who used to start blogs about how Corsi and Fenwick worked are now getting hired in front offices for teams to help tell them, what do these numbers mean? What can I do with my team? How can I make it better? You tell me. And it's just guys who are sitting at home on their couch had a better understanding of the numbers. And it's been an amazing revolution in the NHL. And you can apply it to even games like this where we see Marquette with a 3-0 advantage. And they've had the possession. But now Butler trying to get back into this one 10 minutes into this period. It's a tied period.
And the Corsi number was actually started by Sabres goaltending coach. Back in 2006, he started tracking total shots in the game on net and kind of transpired from there.
Yeah, it's really grown. And the NBA has had numbers like this, and they've had an idea about advanced numbers for a while, and it kind of became public in the last 10 or so years. But like you said, hockey numbers didn't develop until about 2006, and now they've been made public as of last year for the first time, whereas the NBA has been ahead of this. MLB has been ahead of it for years.
Baseball's been ahead of this for a while,
yes. Sabermetrics been, this is what really launched forward the analytics debate, the analytics conversation, and that's where everybody's moving right now.
Back to the game, Arner here with a great glove save.
He's had to make a couple of saves here just now.
Yeah, Butler's putting a little more pressure on here. Marquette hasn't got much going offensively in this period. We're at 9:03 remaining in the second period, 3-0 the Golden Eagles over the Bulldogs. I'm Matt Unger here with Grant Becker on the call, MUTV's own live stream. If you're just tuning in, thank you for joining us.
Second period lull here for Marquette, like our beat writer Jamie Schilling told us to watch out for. Visionary, Jamie. Team's not going to like you if you predict too much stuff like that, and it comes true, though.
That's Matthew Poley. He's on the forecheck. Butler's able to scoop that out, and it gets passed out of the zone. Marquette will have to touch back up for icing, or for offside, excuse me.
Thornley coming out there taking no chances. He's going to freeze the puck the exact opposite of what we've seen Arner do all night. He gloves it and he looks up. Yeah, I'm going to drop this one in. It's just like when you play NHL, no freezing allowed.
Yeah, indeed. Thornley's like, we've been struggling here, so I might want to hold on to the puck this time. A great pass across to Shipa, who starts a rocket, and the rebound's there for the taking. Oh, and a great save from Thornley, and it's loose in front, and Marquette cannot put it in. I don't know how that puck did not go in the back
Thornley
of the net.
Thornley is going to add that one to his highlight reel. What a job to stack the pads there. Saves his team. The puck was still loose in the crease, and his defenders had work to do. Great team defense there by Butler to help out their goalie. He was stood on his head.
And then all started out with the Shipa rocket that Schilling mentioned earlier. A great slap shot that led to a beefy rebound right there for Stillman.
Yeah, I would not want to be on the receiving end of one of those Shipa bombs. Ship bomb.
Ship bomb, you have to trademark that.
I will. Get my patent lawyer on the line. I'm not sure how this works.
Back in the neutral zone here as Kennedy pinches and gives Marquette possession once again. This is Corey Quinn taking it in. It's loose around the boards. Marquette pinching a little higher here, trying to get some offense going as they keep it in the zone and it's cycled back around to the other side. Stillman behind the net here. He loses possession of the puck. There's a guy open in the slot for Marquette, but they opt to go back to the points in Natwara, and he plays it back deep once again. And that's Corey Quinn, and down low, a great pass there, but nothing doing for the Golden Eagles, and it's back to the point for Natwara, who takes a slap shot that is blocked, and that'll trickle out of the zone. Marquette will have to regroup.
Buddy looking for a quick break in there, but team wasn't quite ready for it as they hadn't cleared the zone. Do a nice job to recollect the puck, though.
Despite that, Butler cannot seem to get the puck out, and as soon as I say it, I jinx them, and they do. But Marquette recovers with a great little poke check there from Christian Lately.
Like we talked about, Butler coming out being a different team here in the second period. They have matched Marquette stride for stride here. Neither team's had a whole lot more possession than the other. Marquette's had a couple of good chances. Butler's had a couple of good chances, and the goalies have done a nice job. They both earned those zeros they put up in this period.
Yeah, looks like it's going to be an icing against Marquette, and indeed it is. So we have a draw down in the Marquette zone. We have 6:41 here remaining at the Ponds of Brookfield. Marquette with a 3-0 shutout going on right now. But as Grant Becker has mentioned, quite a different shift in tone here this period. It's been a lot more balanced than the first 10 minutes we saw in the first.
Matt, what do you think those Corsi and Fenwick numbers would have told you about your game growing up playing Pee Wee hockey?
Wow, my game growing up playing hockey was a lot of falling over when I tried to backskate and a lot of tripping in the neutral zone. So I don't think they would be that positive.
Just thought I'd check in with that one.
How about you, Grant? What was your might minor numbers looking like?
Yeah, my might numbers weren't that great, but I improved. I think I kind of hit my stride as a Bantam player.
Yeah.
Maybe around peaked in 8th or 9th
grade.
Yeah,
14, 15-year-old range, you know. That's where you truly become a superstar.
Yeah, I was still small enough to get away with a lot of the chippy little penalties that started getting called on me as I got older. And I'm telling you, those numbers might not have been that bad, because I could hold onto the puck long enough to get hit, get back up, and somehow still have the puck on my stick. You know, made a few passes. My team's numbers overall, though, we weren't very good. I was proud to finish with a 2-20 record my senior year. So,
wow, that is...
Two wins, Matt. That's two wins we didn't have, you know.
That is, yeah.
Wow. But we got them. So we're kind of the anti-Marquette hockey team.
You are the anti-Marquette. You're more of the Butler hockey team here.
You know what, though?
Talent, all
they're having fun.
Yeah.
We're having fun.
Exactly.
The fans are having fun, but they haven't had a whole lot to cheer for in the second period because Butler has done such a nice job to step their game up.
That's a cross-check from behind, so Marquette will have a delayed penalty here as they take in the zone. The bar touches it up, so Marquette will go to the power play with 5:50 remaining here in the second period.
If there was a goalie speed skating contest, Marquette might stand a chance there. Honor, he got there quick. Really fast.
He saw that penalty right away. He started booking it to the bench.
Wonder if he's got his phone on the bench or something. He's trying to text his girlfriend. Who knows?
That's possible.
Maybe he has another motivation.
That is very possible. Or, you know, he might have been a forward in his high school days. He skated pretty well. They always say goalies have to be the best skaters on the ice.
I've always heard that. Never really understood why, but smart people tell me that.
So I'll listen to him, yeah.
Yeah.
Shipout with a good backdoor pass across. And Stillman in the slot. A great save again. And somehow, Thornley is able to keep it out for Butler despite a golden opportunity for Stillman in the slot.
We're going to have to send this footage to Butchie.
Oh, it's Shipaw. There's the Shipaw.
Big, huge slam shot from Shipaw. We talked about that shot earlier. It was one of the first shots we saw in the game, and he absolutely thumped the back of the net there. Hardly needed to get it off the ice. Goalie has to pull his helmet off, take a breather after that one. Boy, did that scare everybody. What a slap. That's the hardest shot I've seen all night.
You do not want to give that man space. Mark Shipaw out of Wildwood, Missouri, with an absolute clap bomb to give Marquette the 4-0 lead, his second of the night. Could we see a Hattie here?
He's certainly in a hat trick range. He's got 25 minutes left to make that hat trick happen. Shipaw with his second goal of the night on a massive ship bomb.
Sadly, I do not have a hat to throw on, so I can't give him the credit he deserves right here.
I do have a hat, but my ears would get cold if I threw it out there, so that's not going to happen. Sorry, Mark.
So Marquette will take the 4-0 lead here with 5:15 left in the go, or 5:15 left in the second period. We're back at even strength here at the Ponds of Brookfield. That's Shipaw with the second of the day. Dolan also added his own, as well as William Podlis, and that is the four Marquette goals that have happened.
That's a third of Mark Shipaw's goals so far this season have come tonight. He only had 4 goals coming into this game. Now he sits at 6 goals, 15 assists. It's not bad for a 6'2" defenseman.
Yeah, defensive putting up some points there. Reminded me of Duncan Keith-esque.
Oh, that's a Blackhawk.
Oh, that is a Blackhawk, yeah. Fine, I'll change it up. I'll go, who's the guy down in Dallas that's been tearing up this year?
John Klingberg.
What a hockey player. Yeah, he's been putting up some numbers this
year. And that's a guy, those advanced numbers would tell you that his leap to success here, it's real, man.
Oh, yeah.
And it's going to keep happening.
Yeah, he has been quite the surprise for the Stars, who are leading the NHL in goals this year. They've been a dominant force with Ben and Sagan up top.
Doesn't get a whole lot better than that. Nothing scarier than that. You would have thought Kessel and Crosby would have been scary. No, Ben and Sagan, that's as scary as it gets.
Indeed it is, and Thornley once again have to freeze it. And Marquette getting a little bit of momentum back here. You can hear the crowd getting a little antsy. I think they want another one.
I think they do, Matt. They were singing earlier. They want another reason to sing. They want another reason to drink. The fans in front of us, these two kids, they've got their cowbell out. They're having a good time. They were happy that they got to use that. 4-0 lead for Marquette. That's an important goal for them.
Marquette keeping the forecheck here. That's Plotz who keeps in, and it cycles around the boards to Telmanic, who holds in and sends it back out to the point. And that is Pody right there, who sends it back in deep for the Golden Eagles. Marquette putting a good little forecheck on here, trying to get themselves another goal before this period expires. 4:18 left in the second here at the Ponce Brookfield.
And let's work our way back to that ship bot goal. That's exactly what you want to do on a power play. If you can't get inside and get that backdoor goal, you go out to the point, you find your big man, you put a lot of guys in front of the goalie, and you make it really, really tough for him. And when you got a guy like ship bot who can absolutely laser beam the puck into the back of the net, let him do it, man. Let him rip it. Let him part the seas. He did, and he finds that goal, and it was absolutely a textbook shot from the point.
Yeah, and for all you basketball fans out there, Butler's been doing a good job of stacking the paint, per se. They've been running a little 2-3 zone, is sending bodies in front, and that is how you beat that zone, is to have a guy that can shoot a puck like that.
Yeah, not letting anybody get to the hoop, but they got Steph Curry out there at the point.
Exactly. Marquette keeping it in here. That's Del Savio. He has the puck in the slot. He dumps it in deep, just trying to keep possession. Kennedy's out front. He's calling for the puck, but he will not get it. And Plas takes a shot, and despite the it squeezes in somehow. Kennedy must have collected the rebound, and it'll be 5-0 Golden Eagles.
It looked to me like Thornley had it covered up, but somehow he didn't. Kennedy does a nice job. You saw Thornley react. You realized he didn't have the puck. We didn't know where it was, but Kennedy did. He put it in the back of the net. He adds to his tally. That's 16 goals in the season for Kennedy, leading this Marquette team.
And that Kennedy right there was grinding hard in front of that. I just mentioned right before he was calling for the puck. He was clapping for it. He had a position on the defender. He worked to get the screen. And you know, you work hard in front of that, good things will happen for you. That's a little Thomas Vanek guess for you.
He's been active all night. And he finally gets rewarded for it. He's been there for a few good opportunities, just hasn't bounced his way yet. And you have to say, a bit unlucky for Butler after such a great period. Marquette turns right around and the goals come quick.
Indeed, as you said, in college hockey, the goals do come quick, and that is two in a 2.5-minute span for Marquette. And
there's three!
And there's three. William Pontus with the second of the night. We have two hat-trick watches on alert here. And Marquette is starting to run away with this one. The wheels are falling off the tracks here for Butler.
Yeah, as I was just saying, Butler's got to feel a little bit unlucky. Now they're going to feel really unlucky. A great period play by them. Marquette at the end just turning it up. No problems. That was another nice team goal. Pod was sending it back against the grain there. And Thornley, you got a feel for the guy. He's been standing on his head this whole period, made some highlight reel saves.
Yeah,
he's looking at that Sports Center top 10. And all of a sudden, three goals just happened like that. It's heartbreaking a guy who's been playing so well.
And as a goalie, as an ex-goalie here, that'll shake your confidence real quick. You feel you're doing all the little things right, and then you can score three goals, and you're just like, how does this happen out here? Where's my defense?
I've been playing so well. What's this all about? No karma in hockey. You just go out there, you play the game, and the puck don't lie.
Lee Barnes applying the forecheck here for Marquette, and they're still pitching hard with three underneath the goalie line here. But Butler's able to squeeze that one out a little bit. Oh, Marquette is able to keep it in. I apologize. And seven, it goes right across the crease, and nothing happening there for Marquette. Looking for their fourth of the period.
Lee Barnes is at the back door there, but nice job by the Butler defense to close down on him. Centerman doing his job, covering up for his defenders.
MUTV's own Kellen Buddy with an attempted long pass at the boards. He's tried a few of those tonight. Nothing happened, and we'll see if one squeezes in.
6-0 Marquette lead over the Butler Bulldogs. 2:25 remaining here in the second period. Grant Becker here on the color with Matt Unger, our play-by-play guy. We're here with Marquette Wires, Jamie Schilling, the hockey beat writer, and Brian Georgeson, tech man, do-it-all guy, Blackhawks fan. Owner of a 300 perfect game. Brian's a heck of a bowler.
He is a heck of a bowler. I can attest to that. I've seen him play at the Annex. He's got a little spin on that baby. Oh, and there's a good save right there from Thornley. Maybe his confidence isn't shaking yet, because that was a nice little snag right there.
And that's what good goalies do, is they bounce back right after a tough stretch and make a nice little save.
That was a great pass to Moreau there from Telemonic from Marquette. Little backhand saucer pass.
And Matt, you said you're a former goalie. What do you say if you're Thornley, you go into the locker room after this period, you say, guys, you got to help me out. What do you say? What do you talk about?
I mean, you really have to just talk to your defenders. They haven't done a good job of clearing guys out of the crease. Kennedy was a sole responsibility for that goal. It was just an average shot from the blue line. But when you have a guy in front of the net, you're not able to see anything. You think you have a frozen, then Kennedy just comes around and just picks it up right in. Your defense has got to do a better job of clearing guys out front. And they really have to be a little more physical here. Arner with a good save. Wow. And that rebound was beefy, but they cannot take advantage of it. Arner's keeping the shutout going here. He's had two this season. Might be looking at a third tonight.
Yeah, if you have any critique of Arner so far tonight, it's that he has given up a couple of those bigger rebounds. They gave a big one up there, but he did a nice job of recovering on his own. That's a quick, quick goalie in net there to be able to recover from that and save a very, very nice shot there from Butler. They did a good job getting the shot off right away, not trying to get too fancy with it. Yep. But Arner adding to his highlight reel.
Bankovic with the shot there on the keeper, and Thornley covers that up, so it's going to be a draw inside the Butler zone. Brian Kennedy, he already has one tonight. He's going to take the draw with his fellow linemate Stillman and DeSalvo.
Ship bomb, nearly the hat trick.
And the goalie's down, and he is able to freeze it. Shippo wanted that one bad. He's looking over the bench right now at his guys. He's laughing. He's got the fishbowl helmet on, so you can see all the emotions
he's
there.
Just, come on, man. I had that one. I had it. And when it came off his stick, you had to think, that one's going to punish the back of the net. Missed just wide.
Here he goes again. Draw again, Shippo. A little greedy there with the shot that gets blocked and goes back to center ice. Might have been a little bit better idea to pass, but, you know, when you're rolling hot with two goals tonight, I don't blame the guy for shooting.
Yeah, man, that's a heat check snapshot there from the blue line. Not too often you see something like that.
That's a really ill-advised pass right there from Butler. Owen, great defensive play right there for number four, Joshua Reisman from Butler to clear that out. He got a hospital puck, I would say, right there.
Yeah, it was Campbell there who was on the receiving end of a tough play, but he did a nice job to recover for his teammate. Opportunity for Butler.
Kyle Corpy on the thing, and he loses his footing. And you can really see, oh, and Marquette looks like they're going to have a breakout here. A 3-on-2. This is DeSalvo. He passes it to Stillman. Oh, and a great save from Thornley. The puck is frozen and almost a 3-on-2 opportunity that was converted for Marquette.
And Thornley read Stillman like a book. Got there, closed off the glove side. No problems for him. But Stillman did a nice job to stay with the play, get it back out, and create an opportunity for DeSalvo. Great job by Thornley to be on top of all of it.
Indeed, we got 31 seconds left here at the Ponds of Brookfield. A 6-0 Marquette lead in the final homestand of the year for them. Their record currently sits at 19-4-2. And they've been undefeated at home since November, and they're proving why tonight, coming out, getting the crowd involved, playing their style of play.
Yeah, Marquette pass heavy, possession heavy. They're a speedy team, so they can win the puck back right away, and that's really why they've had so much possession. It's not necessarily been that they've had the greatest of passes or that they've done a nice job setting up this beautiful offense or anything. It's just they are so gritty, work so hard to get the puck back when they lose it. That'll do it for the second period here, Matt.
That'll do it for the second period. So Marquette will tally on another 3 and match the first period total. 6 in total here. We got hat trick watches right now for Shippa and Paulus. So we will see if they'll be able to convert that in the third period.
Show up. Yeah.
Puck is about to drop here for the third and final period of senior night here at the Ponza Brook for Marquette University. We're welcome back in here with the big dog, MUR beat reporter Jamie Schilling. So Jamie, we already started deep dipping into the postseason for the Marquette Golden Eagles. With the team you've seen tonight, do you think this team can go places?
Absolutely. I mean, it seems the phrase, when it rains it pours, is applicable here. Once one goal's in, everyone starts following along the trend and they just keep adding in. So offensively, absolutely. Defensively, in the opening period, or opening parts of the second, they looked a little rough, but sorry, it's all, crowd's getting a little rowdy here.
And that's what this Marquette team wants. They want to get the crowd into the game. They want to keep them into the game. And for a little while there, Butler did a nice job taking them out of the game. What was it that Butler did differently in that second period, Jamie?
They really just locked down their assignments in the beginning of the second period. It really showed. They were, in the very opening parts of the first part of the game, Marquette was having their way with this team. They were passing it however they wanted. I mean, getting out of three goals was lucky for Butler in the first period, but they've since come on, and I think they're gonna have a very strong third period as well.
And record turnout for the tryouts back in September for the club hockey team. Jurgensen has said this is the most talented team he's coached. Is this the most talented team you've seen here at Marquette?
Absolutely. I mean, it feels like each year Jurgensen's gotten the squad to be a little better, and so, I mean, if they're good now, I'm just imagining them in 2 years, 3 years down the line, if Jurgensen stays, of course.
Yeah, not a huge group of seniors. I know you lose four impact players, but that's not necessarily a huge number. So you talk about four good players, but that's only four guys, you know, and you can replace four guys, and you're not breaking up that whole first line that scored so many goals for this team.
I think it's essential, yeah. You have the main scorers, you have Barnes, you have Kennedy, you have Stillman all coming back, and that's absolutely huge for Marquette. And I think another one that's often overlooked is Robbie Arner comes back for his junior year. And again, he's the guy Jurgensen's described as the man. He says the team success lives and dies with Robbie Arner.
Yeah, we talked earlier about how important it is for teams to possess the puck and how that has a big effect on teams. Well, you can possess the puck all you want to. If the other team takes one shot and scores one goal, you're going to lose. So the goalie position is and always will be the most important position in hockey. And so if Coach Jurgensen can count on Arner, it's going to be huge for this team, especially coming up into this regional tournament.
Absolutely. No, I mean, the one knock I'd say against Arner is he's told me this. He's had a tendency to drop the puck on deflections. I'd say that's probably the biggest weakness of his game, but he's quick. He's has pretty good positioning, and so I think that'll play a long way to see how far Marquette goes into the national tournament.
And here's something we talked about earlier, Jamie, and the last time we talked to you, Marquette in the penalty box.
Yep.
Once again.
It looks like it's tripping to me.
Does this team have a number? Is there a certain number of penalties they're trying to protect? Is there do they have a set goal, or is it just don't take stupid penalties?
All I know is Coach Jurgensen, don't make stupid mistakes. Don't make mistakes that are going to kill you.
Yeah, and that's preached at every age of hockey. You can never make stupid mistakes, and it's the same way with every sport. There are certain things you can control. One of those things is not getting stupid penalties. So when you go ahead and do that, it frustrates a coach every single time.
Absolutely. If you look at one of the past games against Nebraska, it was certainly an issue, and that's what allowed Nebraska to come back and win the game against them. And that's why Marquette ended up not actually winning the Clash of the Corn tournament. So that ended up being a huge factor. So they've done much better in recent games, but still, we want to avoid that box.
Outside of the penalties, what do you think it is that Marquette needs to make sure they're on? But what is it that they need to improve before they head out to the regional tournament?
Turnovers, just bad passes, and that's another huge thing Jurgens will talk about. It's not as prominent as the penalties, but again, it's coaches hate turnovers, and Coach Sherrington is certainly no different.
Yeah, they have been a little sloppy in the neutral zone today. Even guys like Stoneman have tried to make a little bit too fancy of a pass, and come tournament time, we're not going to do that any longer. Those mistakes are going to turn into goals.
Yeah, and that's right there what we just saw is the pass we're talking about. It's those two-line passes. They're a beauty when they work, but they're dangerous.
Yeah.
And it's also these tricky passes right at the blue line where you leave it off for somebody. You can set the other team up for a breakaway.
Oh, good save by Ryrie.
Great save right there. Well, thank you, Jamie Schilling.
Always great to
Marquette
be here.
Warrior beat reporter. He's got all the hot takes. And we're going to go back to the action.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, this Marquette team. Oh, they called that a goal.
Wow.
Looked like that one got in there behind Thorpe. It's a shorthanded goal for the Marquette Golden Eagles. They go up 7-0 here in the third period. We'll have to listen up to find out who gets credit for that goal. That'll make it 7-0 Marquette.
7-0 indeed. I didn't even see that one squeak in. But that will be the first of many here, hopefully, in the third period. Marquette up 7-0 now with 17-22. They're still shorthanded here at the Ponds at Brookfield. And we're going to welcome in our fellow MU Wire reporter, Patrick Thomas. He's going to be on the call tomorrow afternoon, for the Marquette game with Mike Cianciolo. Patrick, what kind of game have you seen so far?
Well, first of all, thank you, Mr. Unger and Mr. Becker, for having me on tonight. It's been a beautiful show right now. 7-0. It's been an absolute showing by the Marquette defense so far, holding Butler 7-0 right now. Absolute domination by this Marquette squad. Very impressive on all sides thus far. I'm really liking what I'm seeing. It's going to be a great game tomorrow when Cianciolo and I are on the call. But thank you again, Mr. Unger and Becker, for having me on the show.
Yeah, what do you think of Robbie Arner's play? You talked about stout defensive play. Arner's had to make a couple of saves. He's been rock solid tonight.
He's absolutely been rock solid. I can't find a single flaw. For all the young hockey fans at home, he's someone you want to model your game after. He's truly a role model for anyone at home watching tonight. He's had a phenomenal game holding this very good Butler squad. They got nothing on the board. They got nothing to show for it tonight.
And it's getting a bit chippy out there. Marquette throws a nice check. Butler comes in and follows it up. Fists are thrown in their back, and everyone goes down to the corner. Refs come flying in. People pinned up against the boards. I'm sure we'll end up with some boys in the box. There's a beer bottle thrown out onto the ice. The fans want a piece of the action.
The beer is being thrown. The blood is being spat. We got a real one.
Speaking of fans, so you've been in the crowd tonight. What's the atmosphere been like down there?
Oh, I got to say, Mr. Unger, it's been a heck of a night down in the student section. The fans, they've come in full force tonight. I got to say, they had to call in an extra bus tonight to get all the fans out there. It's been a tremendous showing. The support that this club hockey team has from the Marquette students is absolutely phenomenal. I'm very impressed with what they've been able to accomplish, their club hockey team, and yet they're able to draw, well, probably more noise than you could say the basketball team has drawn this year.
Hot takes there from Patrick Thomas, and we'd like to thank him for joining. He will be on the call tomorrow with Mike Cianciolo at 1:30 sharp, so make sure you tune in.
Thank you, Mr. Unger and Mr. Becker, for having me on. It's been a tremendous evening. I'll look forward to talking about it tomorrow.
Yeah, enjoy your time in the crowd, back in that great atmosphere. Patrick, thanks so much for coming on with us. Referee's trying to sort out what's going on here. He's giving a little chat to the captains.
I think it's going to be 1-1. It's going to be a 4-on-4 play here with some open ice.
We get some insider information from our beat writer. Jamie Schilling tells me it was Adam Bankovich who was just in a conversation with the ref. He was the goal scorer for Marquette just minutes ago when we thought there wasn't a goal. Yeah, we're going to get coincidental minors here. Looks like it's Marquette's number 10, Eric Plotz. Butler's number 21, Kyle Kortbein.
Yeah, so we're going to have a lot of open ice here to play. It should be fun to watch. 4-on-4 action is always good. You get to see the skills, the dangles, the snippers, and the sellies come out.
Yeah, and it's not too often you see two guys go into the box like this, and then we still have 4-on-4 play. Usually these would be coincidental minors. You stay 5-on-5, and they wait until after the 2 minutes are up, and we get a whistle. But here we're going to go to 4-on-4. It should be fun, that fast-paced hockey coming our way.
Indeed, fast-paced club hockey. You always love to see that. So we have 16 minutes left here at the Ponds of Brookfield. If you're just tuning in with us, MU Wire here on the call. Matt Unger, my best friend Grant Becker over here. Brian Jortson doing some magic out there with the camera. We'd like to thank Jamie Schilling for stopping on, the beat reporter, as well as Patrick Thomas, who once again will have the call tomorrow. We will have another live broadcast tomorrow afternoon, so be sure to tune in.
Man, I can't help but think that you just called me your best friend, and I'm feeling really good about that right now as Marquette's going to go shorthanded here. We're going to have 4-on-3 action.
Wow, talk about some open ice action here.
Heading to the box is Podwals. He's got two goals and now a penalty to his name. And we talked about how Marquette have been disciplined throughout this game. Just one penalty coming into the third period. Now they've had two already, or three already here in the third period. And yeah. When we bring Jamie on, they seem to get penalties. So
I know. Jamie, can you – you're not coming on anymore. No more for the live broadcast for you, Jamie.
It might get interesting, though, if we bring him back out here. We're going to get some – you know, we'll have 3-on-4 for a while.
Yeah, we're going to have 3-on-4 here for a minute and 11. So the shutout might be in jeopardy here for Marquette. Butler can start using the open ice to their advantage. But as you've seen, Marquette has really worn them down. It might be some tired legs out there, and they might have some trouble moving the puck around.
Marquette has a deep, deep bench, no holes in the roster. Not that Butler's got a short bench, but certainly it's not Marquette's, and they've been run all night long. This Marquette team is so quick, so strong, so smart in possession, and Butler coming up the ice here trying to set this one up. Only three Marquette players on the ice.
That's Eric Gentry holding onto the puck. He looks for a pass off front, nothing doing, but he makes a great defensive play to get back and regain possession. And he's still holding off a defender there as he looks around. A nice little backhand pass to his buddy number 8, Hunter Byram. Shot just wide right there from Joey Georgian. It goes back to him at the point. He's looking. He's being patient with all the open ice out here. You want to wait for that perfect opportunity to score. There's no point in taking shots that can get blocked, and then you're just going to have it clear out of the ice down by Marquette.
Yeah, absolutely, Matt. They're looking for a smart shot. Puck gets cleared there, and that's kind of what happens when you take a shot that isn't so great, isn't such a clear-cut opportunity. Setting back up in the zone, and Butler's done a nice job on the power play so far tonight on the few opportunities that they have had outside of that shorthanded goal that Marquette scored.
It's a nice little saucer pass right there, point to point, and Butler's still hanging on to the puck down low here. This is the most possession they've probably had in their offensive end all game. And another open opportunity, but Arner with a great save with the left pad. He kicks it away, and Marquette will clear it down. And it's now 5-on-4 with 31 seconds left on the Marquette penalty. 14:02 here remaining at the Ponds at Brookfield as Marquette still holding on to a 7-0 lead.
Marquette sends the puck down, clearing it once again. Just 20 seconds remaining on this Butler power play.
Marquette's doing a good job of penalty killing on. So they're getting bodies in the lane, they're getting sticks in the passing lanes, and haven't given up that one opportunity for Butler to score.
They are giving a turnover like we talked about.
Yep. Oh, but they do regain it back, and that is Joe Bertain, who's going to take it the other way for the Golden Eagles. He takes a wrist shot, but that is blockered down by Matt Thornley. But Marquette will hold possession here as it is back to even strength, and it's shot, and it is scores.
Very nice goal there for Corey Quinn. Gets the puck in the slot, looks up, finds a little hole on the far side, low on the glove side, puts it right there in the corner, and gives Marquette an 8-0 lead, Matt.
And the goals are just pouring on here at the Ponds of Brookfield. You cannot give a sniper like that an open opportunity in the slot. He's going to bury that, hopefully, every time.
Yeah, you would imagine that opportunity is going to be scored at a pretty high percentage. That's your hockey equivalent of a layup, Matt.
Indeed it is. And Marquette will take an 8-0 lead here with 13:35 remaining in the third period at the Ponds of Brookfield. Marquette really putting the pressure on here. They're not laying off the gas pedal one bit.
No, they certainly are not. And that's not something you can do in hockey, even though it's the third period, even though it's 8-0. They still got to try and score. They got to stay on top of their game. And this is really where Marquette can take advantage and pile on the goals, because they've tired out this Butler team, who's still staying in it. Credit to Butler for doing a nice job working hard until the final whistle here.
Arner snags that one, and you can really tell that Butler is having some tired legs out here. That was an open opportunity for them to maybe get a 3-on-2 rush, and the two attackers behind them just couldn't catch up.
Yeah, you talk about how Marquette's offense has been productive tonight with 8 goals. Their defense has been stifling as well, not giving Butler any good opportunities in their zone. Done so well to clear it early and not allow for any possession.
That's a nice little hit right there from Joe Bertain, who takes down his man, and it allows Marquette to clear the zone. And they're going to push it out here. And it's an offside, so never mind. We will get a faceoff just outside the blue line.
DeSalvo not happy with that call. He thought he had it in possession when he crossed the line, but he's kind of turned around. Awkward little situation. You talk about the Gretzky rule, but that requires some very, very clear possession. I'm not sure that DeSalvo had that. He feels hard done, but I can go ahead and say it's an offside.
And Telmanek wins the faceoff and scoops in the zone right off the draw. So Marquette will have the puck in the Butler zone here as they try to four-track a little bit. And Telmanek pinches in, but Butler's able to squeeze it out. Oh, and it is kept in.
Great pinch right there by Shipbaugh.
Great pinch right there. He's been having a hell of a game all around, offensively and defensively.
Yeah, I would have to say so far, with just 12 minutes left in the game, Shipa has got to be the favorite four player of the game. And it'd be hard for somebody to turn around. He just took a Butler player to the ice without doing a single thing. We're getting a whistle.
He's injured.
Hope that Butler player is all right. He went in for a hit on Shipa, who dipped around him. There was no chance for Shipa to take the hit. The Butler player just goes flying into the boards. We'll hope he's all right. That's number 9, John Frame there. He was looking for the hit. He got up on his own power, though, and it looks like he'll be all right.
Yeah, he's going to the bench, so we'll see if he sits down. We'll keep you monitored on that. Or keep you updated on that, I apologize. We'll monitor it for you.
Shutout still going here for Robbie Arner in the third period. Marquette leading 8-0, 12-19 to go in the contest here at the Ponds of Brookfield. Grant Becker here with Matt Unger. We've been joined tonight by a couple of guests, Jamie Schilling, beat reporter for The Wire, MUTV's Patrick Thomas, who will be on the broadcast tomorrow with Mike Cianciello, and obviously running the camera, the man, the myth, the legend, Brian Georgeson.
Doing a fantastic job, I must add. I haven't seen any instances where the puck has been lost by the cameraman, so you got to credit him there.
Yeah, he's certainly staying on top of it. Brian having a fun time watching this game. You can see the joy in the back of his head.
The joy of a child who just got his first Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. That's what I'll equate it to.
That's a really good metaphor there, Matt.
I mean, I love Reese's Peanut
Butter Cup. It's a simile, like.
I think it was a simile, yeah. Yep. But Marquette doing a good job of keeping in here. That's a great pinch right there for number 12, Mitchell Elena, who's giving Marquette another life here in the zone, but Butler is able to squeeze it out right there, and they will do the little dump and change method they've been trying all game long.
We saw that a lot in the first period, but they did such a nice job in the second period to go away from that, get a little more aggressive. Shipbaugh coming up the ice, looking for another one-man fast break. This is reminiscent of what we saw in the first period.
Indeed, and Shipbaugh, he's taking that puck around the board still. He tries to jam it out front, but a great play right there for number 9, John Frame from Butler, to get the stick in there. A nice little finesse little stick move.
Yeah, and Shipbaugh, he's listed here as 6'2", but I'm going to go ahead and say that if Marquette's big guy, the 6'5" giant out there, Johnny Stillman, if he's 6'5", Shipbaugh's got to be a good solid 6'3". That's not a guy you want to stop. That's how that slap shot gets firing so fast.
Yeah, and I mean, you gotta look at it. Is the measurement taken on skates? Is it off skates?
I'm gonna go ahead and imagine these are off skates. Yeah, so you throw 3 more inches onto these guys, it's some serious leverage out there.
Yeah, 3 more inches on there. You got a guy like Tyler Myers next to Daniel Chower out there, just laying the body. Although Myers is a little bit softer on that side, a little X-Saver guy.
Yeah, certainly is a Daniel Chower could be a good comparison considering the slap bomb that has displayed so far for us tonight.
And Corey Quinn here taking it in the zone, does a little fancy-dancy through-the-legs move, but he has taken off the puck, but Marquette will retain possession. And that's grad student Christian Lee leading his last Friday night, and he put the shot on net. He's not able to finish. Would have been nice to see the grad student on his second last game here at the Ponce Brookfield put one in.
Yeah, it would have been fun for him to get that goal on his final Friday night. He'll have another opportunity here, though, as Marquette takes the draw in their offensive zone. Marquette's been one of the areas in the game that Butler has been successful is in the faceoff circle. They've done a nice job winning draws. That's how they've earned most of their possession. And they do it again here, coming away with the puck.
And that's Butler breaking down from the zone for one of the first times this period as Josh Braun tries to keep it in. He takes a shot. Arner with a little Chester aside save. Does a good job not giving up a rebound and clearing that behind his net. Marquette trying to break out here. This is number 2, Colin Redmond, taking in the zone, all on his own. He gets dispossessed right there by Eric Gentry. A great play from Butler. Butler putting, that's 2 great little poke checks there for the Butler D.
Butler staying active till the closing minutes of this game. Just 10 to go. We're 5/6 of the way through this one. And Butler trails by 8 goals, but they're not done playing yet.
This is Noah Brain from Butler who tries to cut inside. But a nice little play there from senior Brandon Nawara, who's able to chip that one away. And Butler has some possession here in the zone. And it slips around the boards to Eric Gentry. He takes a shot, but that is blocked. But Butler is still holding onto it here in the zone as Noah Gentry sends it to the front of the net again. But Nawara comes away with it, and he gets it out, and Marquette can get on a little bit of a breakout here. And this is number 19, Corey Quinn, who has one tonight already. He tries the same move he just did, and is a little less successful this time.
He dangled it through his own legs before, tried to dangle it through the defender's legs this time. He's dangling.
That's a great pass, and wow, Stillman should have put that one home. That was given to him on a silver platter. He missed it just wide right.
He was looking near post there, but Thornley's had his number so far tonight. Despite the 8 goals that Butler has allowed, Marquette's put a lot of shots on net. Wish we had a real accurate count on that, Matt, because I'm going to go ahead and guess that number is north of 50.
I would venture to say it's north of 60 at this point in the game. They've had a lot of shots that have gone wide, and they've had a lot of shots that have hit the net. He's got to have at least 30 saves out here tonight.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Not a bad performance, and it's hard, though, when you come home and you see the box score and you gave up 8 goals, you know. Doesn't help your goals against average, but certainly his save percentage isn't abysmal or anything. He's done a nice job so far.
Butler with a nice little play there, but they cannot get any traffic in front, and Arner is able to glove that quite easily. That's something they've lacked tonight, Butler. They haven't gotten to the front of the net. You saw Brian Kennedy get in the front of the net for Marquette, earn the little scrappy goal. A lot of screens on the ship off slap shots. You got to give him credit for his own clap bomb that he has, but the pressure in front of the net is always going to help, and Butler's been lacking that. It's just the lack of the forecheck.
And that's, you have to talk about possession there, too. As you have possession, you can set up in the zone. You can have those kinds of opportunities. Marquette looking for the set play there off the faceoff.
Moore with a great pass over to Bankovic, and he makes no doubt about that one. He sinks it high, and it is going to be 9-0 here, Marquette. What a fantastic pass right there from Talmanic over to Bankovic. That is a great assist. That's about as great assist you can ask for.
Yeah, that was a beautiful play. Bankovic was over there all by himself, wide open net. No second guessing, slapped that one home.
He made no doubt about that one.
And Marquette taking the 9-0 lead here with 8:18 remaining in the contest.
And with another draw here, Talmanic, after setting with a beauty assist, he's taking it back in the zone himself, and he only tries to lay another pass off, but nothing doing here for Marquette, and it is scampered back out to the neutral zone as Marquette regains possession. This is Matthew Poley. Sends a little pass across to his friend Kellen Buddy. But Butler with a good little play here to get themselves a break. But Matthew Poley going down to his knee. We see that a lot more in today's game. A lot of defenders, instead of taking away the shot, they give their goal the opportunity, and they'll go down their hands and knees to make sure that pass across gets blocked.
Yeah, it's a good play, too. You say you'll let your goalie handle the shooter. You take care of the pass. Don't make that guy, or don't give that guy the opportunity. And it was Josh Braun there for Butler that was causing problems. He was getting a little chippy with a Marquette attacker on the other side. Came down, did his job offensively, made the break-in play. Nothing comes of it, though, for Butler.
Marquette's able to chip this one in deep to the zone once again. Assistant captain number 12, Mitchell Elena, who has the puck, and he takes the shot, and a nice little glove save right there from Thornley. That could have been a goal, but he kept it away.
Yeah, you look at that shot and you say, hey, wow, that was right at him. I mean, it's a routine save, but the difficulty there is that Thornley's coming across the crease, and the shot came back the other way there by Elena. And it's, like I said, trickier save to make than it looks like.
Yeah, and, I mean, when you're going back across the grain like that, the goalie's really got to stay concentrated on the puck and not lose his positioning in front of the net.
Yeah, he did a nice job there, snags it with the glove, keeps that at 9 goals.
Mitchell Lane with a good little forecheck to help keep in the zone. That's another nice pass right there, and the puck is loose behind the net, and it cycles around the board, and Butler's going to be able to try and chip this one out, but they can't. And that's a real lazy play right there from number 14, Keenan Casey from Butler. He just had to get a stick on that. You can see the tired legs out there for Butler right now.
Yeah, we talked about that all night. At some point, they were going to start running out of gas, and Marquette has run this team so hard all night, and it's starting to add up.
Ooh, Arner with a little rebound there. Marquette does a good job of clearing that in front of their goalie. We've got 6:53 left here at the Ponds at Brookfield. Arner maintaining a shutout for the Golden Eagles. He's going for his third of this season.
He's inching closer and closer. This Marquette team coming into the game had outscored their opponents. What a dangle.
A nice little dangle there from Lee Barnes. But Thornley said no with the right pad. He's able to kick it. And wow, Thornley makes another good play with the stick. He's doing everything out there. And is he going to go to the net? Is he going to go to the box for goalie interference?
Yeah, they're going to take Johnny Stillman to the box. Not sure that was the greatest of calls.
Yeah.
Thornley came out of his net there. As soon as he leaves the crease,
he becomes a player
of his own. If he gets bumped a little bit, he gets bumped. We just had an adult throw his beer out there on the ice. Nobody likes that call.
Yeah, that's
booze raining. Stillman didn't like it. He was shaking his head. Thornley's like, I'll just take the break, man. I need a break right now.
Indeed,
and you can't blame him.
Yeah,
you know?
You can't. I mean, like I said, he hasn't played bad tonight. He's had two or three great saves in the last 3 minutes right there. His defense has got to do a better job clearing out in front of the net, or else this might get a 10 or 11 real quick.
Yeah, he's stood on his head at quite a few different times tonight. Felt a little bit unlucky, and ref's still getting abused.
Yeah, ref is getting heckled right now.
Oh, they're going to give him a 5-minute major, and I can see where the fans are upset now. Not even sure he should be in the box in the first place, and he gets 5. He's going to sit down for nearly the remainder of this game. And Butler's going to be on the power play for a while here. The shutout in danger.
The shutout is indeed in jeopardy as they have it in the zone here. And that is Joshua Braun doing some work down low. But a nice play there from assistant captain Joe Bertain to dispossess him, but Cutler's able to keep it in, and a nice little save there from Arner as he kicks it aside with his left pad, but the puck is still in the zone. It's going to be a long penalty kill here for Marquette.
It is going to be a long penalty kill, and they're going to need to be careful there. Marquette can't get chippy and give him another penalty because you don't want to go down 5-on-3 for 2 minutes at the maximum unless you give up a goal. Nice job there to ice the puck for Marquette. Butler steps in the
lane. Senior Brandon at war with a great little play there as he clears it out and allows his team to get some fresh legs on the ice. And a turnover there, and this is Moreau. He takes a shot, and it goes wide left. Tried to go blocker side and just missed.
Yeah, nearly there was an opportunity there for the third goal for Poldables. And would have been a shorthanded goal to give him a hat trick. Just missed narrowly. Would have been Marquette's second shorthanded goal of the night, but Butler back the other way.
Butler back to the way, but Marquette does a good job of clearing, and they're going to go to the bench and change. A nice solid minute 20 stiff from the PK right there.
Yeah, 3:40 remaining on this Butler power play. With major penalties, they can score as many goals as they want to, and Stillman's not coming out of that box for 5 minutes.
Marquette doing a great job on this PK, though, not really giving them any chances. Surprisingly, the plays are mostly in Butler's offensive zone in this on this power play so far.
Butler going to try and set it up here.
Yeah, Butler taking it back in the zone, but they give it right back away, and that is cleared down by defenseman Eric Plotz. And Butler getting nothing going right now. They got to stop trying to be so fancy, I think. Just dump and chase, set up a little presence here, because they're trying to do too many passes right at the top of the circle.
They've got an extra guy out there. They can get super aggressive with their forecheck, but they haven't done that yet. Marquette comes back the other way.
Yeah, Mitchell Elena here.
On their own.
Mitchell Elena here coming down. He's trying to kill it off a little bit. Passes it back to the point for Christopher Dolan. And Marquette is doing a fantastic job of killing this penalty. I don't think Butler has recorded a shot on a goal yet.
I don't think they have, Matt, but Marquette nearly recorded a goal. And they've played smart hockey here on this penalty kill. And that's what you have to do when you have to kill a five-minute major.
Exactly. Marquette getting some fresh legs out here as Butler tries to break out of the zone. Pass behind the stick of number 21, Kyle Corpin, but Butler is able to chip it into the zone. But Marquette doing a great job of playing defense once again, and that is number 9, Matthew Poley, who takes the puck away. And he's got to get that high off the glass there. That might stay in the zone because of that. And it does indeed, and Butler will retain possession. That's a shot, but a good save by Arner, who kicks it away and does a good job of not giving up the big rebound there.
Yeah, that was a tough shot through traffic, and that's exactly the kind of shot that Butler needs to look for. Arner coming up big when it counts here with just 3.5 minutes to go in this game. Looking forward for Marquette, they've got regionals coming up next week, and they got a game tomorrow, too. One last tune-up before the games really, really count. And what you have to say is that Marquette's played good tonight, but they were certainly the more talented team. It's certainly a game that they should win.
Oh, yes.
And what they need to do now is they need to stop making those long passes, those dangerous passes. Play a little bit smarter. Stop giving up those dumb turnovers. And now we've seen it here in the third period. We've seen some penalties coming back to haunt Marquette potentially. And so those are the two things I think that Marquette needs to improve upon if they're going to advance deep into this regional tournament.
Absolutely, absolutely. And Josh Braun there for Butler, a little cherry picking. He was sitting up top of the blue line calling for the pass, but they couldn't get up. And Marquette's going to break out a 3-on-2 on the power on the PK here.
It's going to go to 4-on-4 play here as it was a tripping.
No,
it's
like high sticking.
A couple of things that could have been called there on Butler. They'll get the call. So Marquette going to 4-on-4 with 2:56 remaining and just a minute 24 left on the Stillman penalty, the major.
Yeah, the major for the questionable goal interference call. I'm still scratching my head in here about that one.
I haven't taken my referee examination in 5+ years, so I really shouldn't be too critical. But either way, Marquette has killed the penalty, and they'll go to 4-on-4 with an opportunity here with less than 3 minutes remaining to make this a double-digit lead.
Tom Monick wins another faceoff. Marquette's done a fantastic job of winning the draws in the Butler zone, and they'll be able to keep it in here. Tom Monick working down low as he tries to swing it back out to the point, and he turns it over there. Oh, he gets it back. Butler should have cleared the puck out of their zone right there.
Nearly came back to bite him in the butt there as Marquette had a good opportunity to score. Butler, little panic move. They're going to ice the puck.
That's going to be nice and right there. So Butler will not be able to change. And Marquette will have a face-off in their zone. We have 2:35 remaining here. It is 9-0 here at the Ponce at Brookfield. The fans are starting to empty out as this game is well out of reach for the Butler Bulldogs.
Yeah, I think it'll be pretty tough for them to come back at this point. We talk about goals coming hard and coming fast, and they come in bunches, but that would be one really big bunch. Matt, we got to start talking about our player of the game with 2:35 remaining. I know we both have a guy we're thinking about. And an honorable mention We should talk about Robbie Arner. He made a couple of big saves. His defense had done a nice job to prevent tough shots, but there were a few times where he had to come up with some saves. He's earned this shutout tonight, his third shutout of the season, if he holds on for the next 235.
Yeah, don't jinx him just yet, but indeed he has deserved a shout. He's done a great job. He was struggling with rebound control early on in the first and even a little bit into the second, but this period especially, he's done a good job of clearing the pucks behind him. He's not giving Butler an opportunity for a second chance goal.
Yeah, your third period star of the game there has got to be Adam Pinkovic. He scored two goals for Marquette. They've had three goals here in this period. So far, three matching periods, 3-0, 3-0, 3-0. Consistent play throughout this game, aside from a little bit of Butler possession there in the second period, where they did a nice job to make some adjustments.
And Eric Gentry, that you can tell he's tired. He just trips on the blue line right there, and he gives the puck right back over to Marquette. And Marquette is about to have a power play in just a few minutes, or just a few seconds, I apologize.
Yeah, 40 seconds remaining on the Stillman major penalty. They're inching ever so close to this power play here, and they'll be on the power play for just over 30 seconds, about 35, when they get the power play.
Marquette doing a good job forechecking here. That's number 8, Christian Lately, the grass doing, who's doing a fantastic job working hard there, putting the body on him. Marquette's able to keep the puck in the zone. Great individual out there by Lately. Marquette keeping the zone here, and Matt Thornley will just freeze the puck. We got a minute 45 left to go here in the final period at the Ponds of Brookfield. That's been a fantastic senior night. The fans were rowdy earlier. The parents were here. We had the cardboard cutouts of all the seniors. Been a great atmosphere here at the Ponds of Brookfield.
Yeah, give it up for the fans who've done a nice job here. And that helps when you're the home team and you got fans behind you. Fan support here on a Friday night. A fun time at the Ponds of Brookfield. They made it a tough environment for this Butler team who had to travel a long ways to fight a good, fast Marquette team, who's won a lot of games this year and scored a lot of goals. They outscored their opponents 150-75 on the season, making that 159-75 so far tonight with just a minute 22 to go. Marquette on the power play.
Yeah, Marquette is on the power play. Their man is out of the box, and they will have about 20 seconds left here to try to get something going before this game is over. Minute 12 left in the game here at the Ponds at Brookfield. A nice little backdoor pass there tried by Bertain, but it's deflected, and Marquette's going to hold in the zone still.
Marquette running a little hybrid kind of overload on this power play.
Yeah.
Running an overload sometimes, other times they'll just throw two guys right in front of that, camping out for that shot from the point.
Nice little pass there. It squeaks out in front, but nothing doing there for the Golden Eagles. And they had a golden opportunity there if that puck just bounced just right.
Thornley freezes the puck with 44.3 seconds left. And I think this is the best time to name our player of the game, Matt. I think you know who it is.
I think it's got to be Mark Shipall today. He's had two fantastic individual efforts. The first goal was him the entire way. He took it end-to-end, finished it off, and then the next one was a fantastic ship bomb, as you would say. And he's also played really well in front of his keeper. He's done a good job of clearing the puck away. Defensively and offensively, star performance. Gotta be the first star for me.
Yeah, let's not forget, he's a defender. He's a
exactly.
Defender first, and he's posting a shutout tonight, helping his goalie Robbie Arner out. And he scored a goal that Coach Herb Brooks would not have liked, going coast to coast, end to end, but he also scored a goal that Coach would have loved, that huge bomb from the point.
Yeah.
The goal of the night so far, it was a team goal and a great individual slap.
And we got 19 seconds left here at the Ponds at Brookfield, and this one is just about over. Marquette cycles it across the zone. They're about to rep this one out. A Butler player breaks a stick right there at center ice, number 21. Kyle Cordovan, he's upset about this loss, and I can't help but be upset as well if I lost 9-0.
Yeah, tough one here for Butler after a great performance by Marquette. This has been the MUTV live broadcast here from the Ponds of Brookfield. We got to thank everybody who was a part of this tonight. We got to thank Patrick Thomas for coming on and joining us. We got to thank Marquette Wire reporter Jamie Schilling for coming on and joining us. And Jamie's still got work to do because he's got to write after this one. Got to thank Brian Georgeson for setting all this up, taking it all down, because we're going to leave. We're going to take the van and go home. Brian's going to be here working on this stuff all night.
Yeah, we're going to get Chick-fil-A, and Brian's just going to take everything home, right, Brian? That's
yeah,
how it works.
So thanks in advance for that, Brian. You did such a nice job on the camera tonight, but your work's not done. And it's been fun being on here with you, Matt. Thanks so much for having me.
Grant, it's been a fantastic time. Great atmosphere here at the Ponds of Brookfield as Marquette will now move to 24-2 on the season as they look ahead to Nationals. We'll see you next time, guys.